Hello everyone. This is putting together quite a few concepts from earlier videos. So I'm going to discuss model context protocol, how to make your own MCP server, your own server that can work with Claude, desktop, cursor, or Goose, or your own client. I'm going to look at how to Dockerize your MCP server. That's obviously useful for distributing it to other people. Sandbox your code a bit more effectively. And yeah, let's get going. So first thing, build your MCP server. We'll look at that. Dockerize it, and then how to use it, because there is some specific syntax if you want to either add it to the config.json for Claude or for Goose or for whichever client. It's going to be fairly similar. So build your MCP server. There's a really good way to do that, which is, we open this. It is a boilerplate example that you can take and you can use. And that is, if it's not opening a new window, there we go. It's on GitHub, create Python server. And if you follow the instructions, you can install using UVX or pip. I prefer using UV now, but UVX create-mcp-server. Once you've done that, you can do, you create it with the name, but keep the name sensible because you don't want it over verbose, but you obviously want it meaningful. If you call it my server, you need to then obviously CD into that. UV sync dash dash dev all extras UV run my server. These are kind of the instructions for just actually running it. But as you can see, it uses the Python SDK, which is good. You could just use the Python SDK. You don't have to use this. This is just kind of a tip from me. Anyway, that's how to create the server. And there's loads of examples here that you can refer to. However, this is using a notes example. So I don't know if it's in here. The template actually uses Ginger. And examples, I think they're elsewhere. But I think it's quite widely covered on how to, especially with the Python SDK, the documentation there. There we go. There are the examples. And servers, if you go in there, you've got either the fast MCP version or the non-fast MCP version. Fast MCP does make a few things easier for you. I've done a video on that one, the screenshot one. So if you add an MCP tool, or you need to create an MCP tool, which is you can have a tool, resource, or prompt. If you want to do that, then you can do MCP and equals the instance of fast MCP. And then you do the at MCP decorator with dot tool. You'll probably want to be building tools most of the time. You can do resources and prompts. Write the Python code. Here we're doing something with screenshots, so we're using PyAutoGUI, and then we're saving the file. So this is kind of a normal Python function, but it's got the MCP tool wrapper on it. So it's a nice way to do it. It's you're not getting too deep into the intricacies of the MCP protocol. You're using it without having to understand every single bit behind the scenes. So Dockerize. What I did to learn this was I looked at the GitHub repo for SQLite MCP server. Because I was having, if you watch my previous video, you'll see how I was having issues with how to actually get the server running and how to keep it running. And here you see the important part that I was making the mistake with was the entry point. Now the entry point will become, if you copy what I've done here, obviously instead of MCP 360, you put in your own name, you could and the source. So that's whatever you call your project when you do the MCP create server, if you're using the template. PyProject.toml, that's if you use UV. If you're not using UV, you will still use pip with requirements.txt. So you'll copy your requirements.txt So you're copying all of these, all of this stuff into your into Docker, and then you're running, you're mounting, you count some mounts, and then you're adding your source code inside of the container, which will be app/, and then the name of your project. Mine was Python 360. I covered a couple of issues in the previous video that I had, because I stupidly changed. I didn't keep the name of my project the same as the name of what I wanted to call my entry point. So, bit of advice, keep the name of your entry point the same as the name of your project. It just makes life easier. So, pause this, copy it, or you can go to my GitHub, the link's in the other video. So, what I want to cover more here is actually how to use it. So, I've shown how to create a server in Python. I've shown how to Dockerize it in the last video. But here, I actually want to show you how to use it. I don't have Cursor or Claude desktop. I don't subscribe to them. I may or may not, probably not, because of money. But Goose is a free text-based client that will work with MCP Server. So I'd recommend that if you want to develop MCP servers, test them such that you will know that they are fully compatible with whatever the end user uses. So whether the end user uses Claude, Cursor, Goose, whatever, the whole point of the protocol is it's consistent. So let's just go full screen again. When you use Goose, so Goose, you go to, I forget the name of the website, but you can Google it and you can install Goose. Once you've got Goose installed, you do Goose configure, and then you do add extension, command line extension. Then you tell it the name of the extension. That's like a label. This is the important bit. So just go to the next slide. There we go. That's a bit clearer. So Docker. Oftentimes, you'll see UVX run for the Python examples, especially on the model context protocol.io website, GitHub repo, whatever. You'll see UVX run, or you'll see the TypeScript commands. So you've got UVX for the Python stuff, and you might not want to. You might actually just want to run your Docker container with your MCP server inside it so that it's sort of sandboxed or isolated, especially if it's running some Python code that could do some file deletion or whatever. So put it inside a Docker container, set the timeout. At the timeout, whatever you want. Would you like to add environment variables? In my case here, I didn't. So then it said added. It confirmed it had added it. I'm using ChatGPT 3.5 Turbo, as you can see, is my LLM provider. You can choose Anthropic, Grok, Google. So Goose is running, enter your instructions. Right, let's break down what we actually, so I've covered the Docker file in the previous video, I've covered how to use the create server to actually create a server. We've looked at the screenshot example, you could copy that if you wanted. So to actually put it inside Docker, use the Docker file. Once you want to use it, once you've done the Docker build, you've actually built it, Docker run, and then it's -i to keep it interactive so that it keeps stood in open even if it's not attached, so you can interact with it through the terminal or via your LLM. --rm automatically removes it when the container exits. --init, so it runs an init process inside the container that forwards signals and processes, helps zombie process, blah blah. Right, --e Docker container equals true. It sets environment variables inside the container if you've got some. So it's setting Docker_container to true. You can read all that. And then the important bit is mcp-360. That is the name of what I called it when I built it. You can see the screenshots there. If you like these videos, don't forget to subscribe. They take a bit of effort. So, and hopefully this is material you probably will not find anywhere else. Almost certainly you won't. So the container's running in the background, and you see that's the image was MCP 360. Then the command, you can see all the Docker stuff. So I'm not an expert in Docker, but I've worked out enough to actually be able to use it. So that's there. So how do you actually know that it's available? So you, with Goose, it's really good. You can list your, this is actually ready to talk to the LLM, and I've just done so. So I kind of asked it what tools it could see, and then it knew that it had this MCP 360 extension. And that actually is this local container, which is running a Docker desktop. So a lot of the Docker MCP instructions you will see will be for Dockerized MCP servers that are already hosted remotely on Docker. What I'm showing you here is how you can have your own Docker image, host it locally on your same laptop that you're running your LLM client, i.e. Goose or Claude Desktop. So it's the whole point of this is how you can have you can Dockerize your own server and you can do what you want with it, and you don't have to host it on Docker, so in order to be able to pull it down or use it. Because I think with a lot of the examples, they are all hosted MCP servers that are up there in the third party. But what if you want to build your own and you want to use it within in your own company, data privacy and all that? So, right, let's exit that. And Goose configure. So what would you like to configure? Configure providers, add extension, toggle extensions, remove extensions, Goose settings. Let's just go to toggle extensions. If you want to turn one of them off, so developers there by default, MCP, let's turn that off, press enter, and it's updated the JSON file in the background. So if we want to add it again, we would do goose configure, add extension, command line extension. Now I'm just using the up and down arrows and enter here. So then I would call it, just call everything the same. If once you start, once you don't, it gets messy. So there, I want to do Docker run -i -rm -init -e Docker container equals true, and then MCP360. That's a dash. Okay, enter the timeout, just 11. Would you like to add environment? I don't in this case, but if you had API keys and everything like that, you may well want to. Added the extension. So then we do goose. Let me just do clear the screen so it goes up to the top, and then goose session. It takes a while, so Goose is running. And this is again where you just want to check what tools do you have MCP servers. And there you just saw it knows about the MCP 360. So that's the MCP server I wrote in Python that I Dockerized, that I then specified in Goose. But for Goose, you could be using Claude Desktop, Cursor, or whatever, any other client that works with MCP. And that's the whole benefit of the MCP protocol. It's compatible with anything that uses a protocol. So there we go. That's a quick roundup. I hope this has been useful because, as I say, this is, I've collated all this myself. I've used a few things for reference, like this SQLite Docker file from the MCP server. But I think this is unique, this video, in that I'm showing you how to write an MCP server in Python, because many are types, they use TypeScript. I'm showing you how to do it in Python, which is nice, which is simple. The code looks like a standard. If you use the fast MCP input, then the code just has the @mcp.tool, and then you do def with name of the function. Then you can Dockerize it, and the Docker container runs locally. You're not pulling it down from a third-party repo. So this is really good for business, for data privacy and so on. You can see how many tests I've been doing. So 156 megabytes, it's not tiny, but it's not huge either, so I think that's pretty good. So MCP server written in Python, Dockerized, and then used with a cursor, Claude, or MCP compatible client. So thank you for watching. Thumbs up, subscribe. These videos take a bit of effort, and they might not be slick, but they take me quite a long time to do the research and the code and the testing, and not everything I do works first time, so it's time consuming, and I'm on a bit of a shoestring, so yeah, I'm not begging, but yes, I am. Thanks for watching. See you next time.